This is the Space Shuttle Discovery, on display at the Smithsonian Institution's National Air and Space Museum, Stephen F. Udvar-Hazy Center in Chantilly, Virginia. The Space Shuttle is a very unique museum artifact. To call an artifact by its name makes it feel almost human. Discovery. From the nose to the top of the vertical stabilizer, she is amazing. 39 trips to space, 365 total days spent there, 5,830 trips around the Earth. Really staggering numbers. The list of missions accomplished using her encompass all an orbiter could do. Launching satellites, probes, deploying the Hubble Space Telescope, releasing science payloads. Both returned to flight missions after tragic losses. Standing near Discovery is humbling and completely awesome. Today is an unforgettable day, though. Let's go inside and take a look around. Entering the crew compartment for maintenance and inspections is pretty complex. We have help today from former shuttle engineers using their special tools to open the hatch. Climbing inside, as you can see, the space is pretty cramped. Just inside the hatch, though, is a critical piece of equipment. We are in the crew compartment of the Space Shuttle Discovery. And one of the questions we get most here at the museum is, how do you go to the bathroom in space? Well, this is where it happens. You can see the Space Shuttle toilet here looks really complicated to use. Instead of gravity pulling waste down like it does in a normal toilet, gentle suction forces things in the right direction. Like an airline restroom, this has lots of compartments for supplies and a handle to flush. Just make sure you always close the door. Now you can see the middeck, where most of the living and working goes on. The lockers are storage for everything from science experiments to cameras to clothes and food. And of course, there's lots of Velcro. When the astronauts were ready to eat, they used the warming oven in the galley unit. Food packets were put inside to warm up while crews worked. They also used the galley to rehydrate foods with hot or cold water. The crew seats are still installed in the middeck, folding and unfolding easily for stowage while the space shuttle was in orbit. Like a race car, astronauts had serious safety harnesses to wear during launch and landing. Getting up to the flight deck is challenging in 1G. On orbit, just floating up was far easier than using a ladder. Right now, we're on Discovery's flight deck, and I'm in the seat where the commander of the mission would sit. And one thing you definitely notice up here are just how many switches, screens, and gauges there are. The flight deck is the upstairs part of the orbiter, where the commander and pilot maneuvered the vehicle during flight and to a safe landing. Each seat has a control stick, just like an aircraft, and smaller knobs to make smaller movements. Lights keep the space well lit in all conditions, especially the 16 nights experienced in a single 24-hour period. Almost everything can be controlled from here, including work in the payload bay. Windows out the back and above help crew at the aft flight control station use the robotic arm and dock with other vehicles. The payload bay doors are closed on Discovery, but you can see them open if you visit the Space Shuttle Atlantis at the Kennedy Space Center in Florida. For as much as it could do, Discovery isn't very modern, with all of the hundreds and hundreds of switches. The airlock is where spacesuits were stored. Here, astronauts would put on their spacesuits and take them off once they were done. You can see the control equipment for getting the suits ready, and they're upside down. Astronauts in suits could see better by leaning over rather than turning their heads. Above is the centerline camera. It helped line up the airlock top hatch with the International Space Station for proper docking.
Welcome to Discovery's Payload Bay. This is the area from which Hubble, ISS modules, and other satellites would be released into space.
Here along the starboard side, you can see the robotic arm boom, an extension to the arm, which is now on display outside of Discovery. The yellow handles are for astronauts to move during a spacewalk, hand over hand, all around the payload bay. And the camera in the center helps keep an eye on their work. Looking back at the airlock, this space is gigantic, as big as a school bus. Under the white blankets are lots of vehicle systems. You can see one section open here near the airlock. The doors overhead were open most of the orbiter's time in space. They have radiators on them to shed all of the heat created by operating Discovery. Thanks for joining us on this look inside Discovery.